Adenovirus infection causes a whole group of acute infectious diseases that occur with a mild intoxication syndrome and damage to the mucous membranes of the upper respiratory tract, lymphoid tissue, eyes or intestines. Adenoviruses were first isolated in 1953 from children with SARS and acute respiratory viral infection, occurring with conjunctivitis W. Rowe. Subsequently, numerous animal studies have shown the oncogenicity of adenoviruses, that is, their ability to provoke the development of malignant tumors. Adenovirus infection is widespread. In the overall structure of the incidence of viral infectious diseases, it accounts for 10%. The incidence of adenoviral infections is recorded everywhere and year-round, with a peak in the cold season. The disease can be observed in the form of epidemic outbreaks, and in the form of sporadic cases. Epidemic outbreaks of adenovirus infection are most often caused by viruses of types 14 and 21. Adenoviral hemorrhagic conjunctivitis is caused by type 3, 4, or 7 viruses. Extremely rare manifestations of adenovirus infection such as hemorrhagic cystitis and meningoencephalitis are observed. Adenovirus infection affects children and young people with a greater frequency. In most cases, the duration of the disease is 10 days, but sometimes it can take a relapsing course and last up to several weeks. Causes and risk factors. The causative agents of adenovirus infection are DNA-containing viruses belonging to the genus master adenovirus of the Adenoviridae family. Currently, specialists have described more than 100 serological types of adenoviruses, about 40 of them have been isolated from humans. All adenovirus serovars vary significantly in epidemiological characteristics. For example, viruses of types 1, 2, and 5 can cause damage to the upper respiratory tract in young children, in which the virus persists in the lymphoid tissue for a long time. Viruses of type 4, 7, 14, or 21 cause the development of inflammation of the upper respiratory tract in adults. Type 3 adenovirus is the causative agent of pharyngoconjunctival fever, adenovirus conjunctivitis, in adults and older children. In the external environment, adenoviruses are quite stable. At room temperature, they remain viable for 15 days. Chlorine-based disinfectants and ultraviolet rays kill them in a few minutes. Adenoviruses tolerate low temperatures well. For example, in water at a temperature of 4 degrees Celsius, they retain their viability for more than 2 years. The source and reservoir of infection is a sick person or a virus carrier. After the disease, the virus is secreted with the secret of the upper respiratory tract for another 25 days, and with feces, over 45 days. The mechanism of transmission of adenovirus infection in children and adults is most often aerosol, suspension of droplets of mucus, saliva in the air, but alimentary, fecal oral, can also be observed. Very rarely, infection is transmitted through contaminated environmental objects. The susceptibility of people to adenovirus infection is high. After the disease has persisted, immunity remains. However, it is type-specific and therefore repeated cases of the disease due to another virus serova may occur. With the aerosol route of infection, adenovirus enters the mucous membrane of the upper respiratory tract, and then migrates through the bronchi to the lower section. The entrance gate can also be the mucous membrane of the eyes or intestines, into which the virus enters with the particles of sputum at the time of ingestion. Further reproduction of the infectious agent occurs in the epithelial cells of the respiratory tract, small intestine. In the lesion focus, inflammation begins, accompanied by hyperplasia and submucosal tissue infiltration, expansion of its capillaries, and hemorrhages. Clinically, this is manifested by pharyngitis, tonsillitis, diarrhea or conjunctivitis, often of a filmy nature. In severe cases, adenovirus infection can lead to the development of keratoconjunctivitis, accompanied by persistent clouding of the cornea and visual impairment. From the primary focus of inflammation with lymphatic flow, the virus enters the regional lymph nodes, causing hyperplasia of the lymphoid tissue. As a result, The patient develops mesenteritis and lymphadenopathy, an increase in tissue permeability and suppression of macrophage activity leads to the development of viremia and the introduction of adenoviruses into various organs, which is accompanied by the development of intoxication syndrome. Adenoviruses are fixed by macrophages in the liver and spleen cells. This process is clinically manifested by the formation of hepatilional syndrome. An increase in the liver and spleen occurs. Forms of the disease, according to their ability to cause agglutination, gluing, of red blood cells. Adenoviruses are divided into four subgroups, according to the prevalence of certain symptoms in the clinical picture or their combination. The following forms of adenovirus infection in adults and children are distinguished: acute respiratory viral infection, RV, rhinopharyngitis, rhinopharyngotonsillitis, rhinopharyngobronchitis, pharyngoconjunctival fever, conjunctivitis, keratoconjunctivitis, pneumonia. Symptoms of adenovirus infection. The incubation period for adenovirus infection lasts from 24 hours to 15 days, but most often its duration is 5-8 days. The disease begins acutely. The patient has mild symptoms of intoxication, decreased appetite, adenomia, general weakness, muscle and joint pain, mild headache, slight chills. On 2-3 days from the onset of the disease, body temperature rises to subfebrile values and lasts 5-8 days. Only occasionally can body temperature rise to 39 degrees. In rare cases, symptoms of adenovirus infection may include frequent loose stools and abdominal pain, more common in children. Along with symptoms of intoxication, signs of inflammation of the upper respiratory tract occur. Patients complain of nasal congestion with copious discharge of an initially serous and then serous purulent character. There is a sore throat, a dry cough, after a few days, profuse lacrimation and pain in the AS join them. When examining patients, they pay attention to hyperemia, redness of the face, injection of sclera. In some cases, a papular rash appears on the skin. With adenovirus infection, conjunctivitis often develops, accompanied by mucus discharge. In young children, swelling of the eyelids quickly increases, membranous formations appear on the mucous membrane. With untimely treatment, the inflammatory process can spread to the cornea, leading to the formation of infiltrates. Conjunctivitis with adenovirus infection is first unilateral in nature and then becomes bilateral. After recovery, resorption of corneal infiltrates occurs slowly. The process can continue for 1-2 months. In many cases, adenoviral conjunctivitis is combined with pharyngitis. This form of the disease is called pharyngoconjunctival fever. When examining the oral cavity, slight reddening of the posterior pharyngeal wall and soft palate is noted. The pharyngeal tonsils are slightly hypertrophied and loosened. In some cases, a whitish coating, easily removed with a cotton swab, is located on their surface. The submandibular, and sometimes cervical and even axillary lymph nodes increase in size and become painful on palpation. The most serious manifestation of adenovirus infection in children and adults is adenovirus pneumonia. Usually it occurs on the 3rd-5th day of the disease. Only in children of the first years of life an adenovirus infection can immediately manifest an inflammatory process in the lung tissue. Symptoms of adenovirus pneumonia are increasing general weakness, cough, dyspnea, nasolabial triangle cyanosis, excessive sweating. Adenoviral pneumonia can be either small focal or confluent, that is, covering several segments of the lungs simultaneously. In children of the first 3 years of life, adenovirus pneumonia often takes a severe course and is accompanied by the appearance of a maculopapular skin rash, the formation of foci of necrosis in the skin, brain and lungs. Lesions of the cardiovascular system with adenovirus infection are extremely rare and only in severe infectious and inflammatory processes. Their characteristic features are systolic murmur at the apex of the heart and muffling of its tones. Inflammation of the respiratory tract with adenovirus infection in children, much less often in adults, is often combined with damage to the organs of the gastrointestinal tract. Patients develop pain in the abdomen, diarrhea, and the spleen and liver increase. Diagnostics. Adenovirus infection requires differential diagnosis with a number of other pathologies: pneumonia, tuberculosis, diphtheria, conjunctivitis and keratitis of a different, not adenoviral, etiology. Acute respiratory infections of a different etiology, including flu. The main diagnostic criteria for adenovirus infection are moderate intoxication, signs of damage to the respiratory tract, conjunctivitis, lymphadenopathy, regional or common, exanthema, hepatilional syndrome, violation of the digestive system. In the general blood test for adenovirus infection, no significant changes are noted, except for a slight increase in ESR. Virological studies of the discharge from the nasopharynx and eyes, allowing to obtain a virus culture in clinical practice, are not used due to the high complexity and cost, as well as the duration of the study. For a retrospective diagnosis of adenovirus infection, type-specific PCR/TGA and group-specific CSC are performed. Reactions with paired sera obtained on the first day of the disease and during the period of subsidence of clinical manifestations. The increase in the titer of serum antibodies at least 4 times confirms the presence of adenovirus infection. For an indicative diagnosis of adenovirus infection, the method of immune electron microscopy and RIF can be used. Treatment of adenovirus infection. With an uncomplicated course of diseases caused by adenovirus infection, the patient is prescribed bed rest and a heavy drink is recommended. When signs of conjunctivitis appear, instillation of eye drops with an antiviral effect is indicated. To normalize body temperature, relieve headaches and muscle pain, non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs are prescribed. In some cases, the use of vitamin preparations and antihistamines is justified. With complicated adenovirus and the addition of a secondary bacterial infection, detoxification therapy is carried out. Intravenous administration of glucose and saline solutions, ascorbic acid, and broad-spectrum antibiotics are prescribed. In severe adenovirus infection, treatment is carried out in a hospital setting. For prophylactic purposes, antibiotics for adenovirus infection are used only in elderly people suffering from chronic bronchopulmonary diseases, as well as in patients with manifestations of immunosuppression. Possible consequences and complications. The most common complications of adenovirus infection are sinusitis, otitis, obstruction of the Ostarchon tube, resulting from a prolonged increase in the pharynx of lymphoid tissue, false croup, laryngospasm, bacterial pneumonia, pyelonephritis. Forecast. The forecast is generally favorable. In most cases, the disease ends in complete recovery within 7-10 days. Prevention. In some countries, a live vaccine for attenuated viruses is being vaccinated to prevent adult adenovirus infection. But in most countries, including Russia, immunization is not carried out, as there is an opinion about the ability of adenoviruses to lead to malignant cells in the human body. For the prevention of adenovirus infections, it is important to follow sanitary and hygienic rules, to control the regularity and correctness of the chlorination of water in pools.